Hello. Hello students, good afternoon. Today's presentation we are going to see about the oil and gas well drilling technology basics. So what are the systems? What are the operations in oil and gas well drilling technology? So I already posted two videos on rotary drilling components. And the links also I have given in this presentation at the end of the lecture, and you can visit my channels. There are three, four videos, and the basics of oil and gas well drilling technology. Let's go to the presentation. So, introduction to oil and gas well drilling. So, in petroleum engineering, so why we do the drilling? So, what is the necessity and what are the types of drilling and what are the components and all these things we can get introduced in this brief presentation. So, why we are doing the drilling? What is the prospect of selection? What is the historical background? The modification in drilling and what are the types of drilling and what are the different well locations in terms of drilling and conventional drilling rig components and what are the advances in the rotary drilling and what are the different types of muds usages and what is a successful drilling operation. So this is the brief content of this presentation. So why we do the drilling in the oil and gas engineering? So well drilling is very one of the important operation in petroleum engineering. Apart from production, reservoir, etc., production, reservoir engineering, and other techniques like enhanced oil recovery, modeling, etc. The drilling engineering, oil well drilling plays a key role in petroleum engineering. So why we do the drilling? So you have to know the subsurface and you have to get the water from the underneath and also you have to get the black gold, that is oil and your gas. So what we do? Subsurface, what is present below the 2,000 feet, 10,000 feet, 8,000 feet? So you had to do the geological survey initially and geological prospecting. Then we will do the seismic surveys, etc. Then we will study the reservoirs. Then we will go further for drilling and production engineering. Then prospect selection. So you know there are different types of wells. So in case of production wells, the prospect of selection is, so it should be identified. And we have to maintain or increase the reservoir production. That is petroleum production engineering. And in the exploration wells, we require all the geological, geophysical data gathering, processing, and evaluation like surface geological studies, mapping, subsurface mapping, identification of structures, rocks studies, anticlines, salt domes, fault traps, and sand bodies, and other things. And also we will do the seismic evaluation. So that is the production well and exploration well. And abandoned well means once there will be a no water, once you do the drilling or there will be a no water or no gas, nothing. So we will do the well abandoned. So after few years or few months, once if you don't get any flow, so we will close the well, that is abandoned wells. So production well, exploration well, and abandoned wells. Then historical background. So in 1808, the first commercial well was done by the Chinese. So they drilled the well in 1808, the first commercial by Chinese. Then the percussion drilling. Then, in 1859, so cable tool percussion drilling has been done, and in 1918, well, deepest well by cable tools up to 7,386 feet they are done. And 1930, so there is a rotary drilling has been started. So this is the basic historical background. Then modification in drilling. So what are the differences or modifications? So you know that rotary drilling, then cable tool drilling, then CTD, coil tube drilling. So cable tool by the pounding action of the drill bits, and rotary drilling, we use the rotary action of the drill bits in the rotary table. And in the coil tubing is used for the horizontal and multilateral drilling, that is coil tubing. Modification in drilling, that is rotary drilling, coil tubing and cable tool drilling. The next one, so what are the different well locations in terms of drilling? So onshore and offshore. So in the land rig, so we'll call it as a onshore drilling, and offshore means in the sea. That is, we are using the different offshore structures like semi-submersibles, jackups, then TLPs, tension leg platforms, etc. That is your offshore drilling. So that is the difference between the onshore and offshore drilling. Sir, we are carrying out the drilling operation in the sea with the help of deep offshore technology. So here in the offshore technology, you know that in the land rig, we use the directly from your well, from the surface to the your bore, we are doing the directly without anything. That means, it means that directly you are doing the drilling, and with the help of casing pipes and BOPs, etc. But in the offshore, we are using the marine risers. So there is a risers from your oil well which is present in the subsea surface, but we have to bring it to the top of the surface. So we use the risers, marine risers. So that is the difference between onshore drilling and offshore drilling. Then basic drilling rig functions, you know that hoisting system, derrick, drawworks, blocks, then hook. That is your hoisting system. So all these things we have discussed in the our previous videos, which I put in the in our channel. So you can visit rotary drilling components 1 and 2, and rotating system, hoisting system, rotating system, so rotary tables, swivel, keel, etc. So this is the basic drilling rig functions. Then circulating system, then well, controlling system. Circulating means standpipes, solid control equipments, pumps, etc. Solid control, so we all the, what do you call, degasser, desilter, mud pumps, all these things. So solid control devices, that also we have discussed. Then well, control equipments, controlling is BOPs, choke manifold, choke system, etc. Then rig components, hoisting system, the function of a derrick, the derrick. So what is the meaning of derrick? So the function of derrick is to provide a vertical clearance to raising the and lowering of a drill string into and out of the borehole. That is the function of your derrick. It has to provide vertical clearance for raising and lowering of your drill string. There are two types of derricks. That is your standard derricks. It's a lot of bolted construction and assembled part by part. That is your standard derrick, you can see, and must. That is a portable derrick, one which is capable of being erected as a single unit. So that is your must. Then crown block. That is in hoisting system. So it is a fixed set of pulleys called sheaves located at the top of your derrick or must, over which the drilling line is threaded. That is your crown block. Then traveling block and the pulley, that is pulley assembly or sheaves, that connects the drilling line to the hook and swivel. Then So drawworks is the control center from which the driller operates the rig. So it contains clutches, chains, and other controls. And also it houses the drum, which spools the drilling lines during the hoisting and allows the feed off during the drilling. That is where drawworks. Then Kelly. So Kelly is here. You have different types of Kellys: hexagonal Kelly, square Kelly, of pipe. So length of pipe that fits into the bushing in the rig's rotary table. You can see in the right hand side, as the rotary table turns into the right, the Kelly turns with it. The main function of the Kelly is to transfer the energy from the rotary table to the rest of the drill string. That is your Kelly. And swivel, it suspends the drill string and allows the rotation at the same time. That is swivel. So drill pipes, so which furnishes the necessary length for the drill string and serves as a conduit for the drilling fluids. So we have the heavyweight drill pipe, lightweight drill pipes, different type of drill pipes are available. You can see the diagram. Then drill collars. So the drill collars provides weight and stability to the drill bits and maintain the tension on the drill pipe and help the hole on the straight course. That is your drill collars. So you can see the drill pipe and drill pipe buckled then. So this is your drill collars and drill pipes. The next one, so heavy wall drill pipes, which provides the additional hole stability and aids in directional control and stabilizes, that is centralize the drill collars and helps to maintain the hole, the full gauge diameter and jaws, which provides the sharp upward or downward impact to free stuck pipes. Reamers help to maintain full gauge hole in diameter. Then crossover subs, which join components having different types of connections. So you can see the right hand side, swivel, Kelly cock, Kelly saver sub, drill pipe, drill collars, and your drill bit. Then drill bit. So you have the most critical component in the rotor drilling operations. Two types of main types of bits, that is your PDC bits, roller cutter bits. It consists of cutting elements which are arranged on cones, which may be 3-cone bit, 4-cone bit, and rotate on bearings about their own axis as the drill strings turns the body of the bit. So these bits have teeth or buttons. And fixed cutter bits, also known as drag bits, consist of stationary cutting elements which are the integral with the body of the bit and are rotated directly by the turning of the drill string. So the principal types of fixed cutter bits are natural diamond and PDC, polydiamond crystalline or polydiamond polycrystalline diamond compact beads. So I also put 2-3 videos on my channel about the roller cone beads. So you can watch the videos. So this is your circulating system. You can see the circulating system. So you can see the mud pump suction line. So we have the mud tanks, desilter, shell shaker, etc. So you can see the from your suction line. So the mud pump, all the solid drilling fluids has been taken to your circulating system. So these are the main equipments in the solid control removal or circulating system. So you can see here clearly. The next one, circulating system, where the mud pumps so function is to circulate the drilling fluids at the desired pressure and volume. That is the role of your mud pumps, and the pump is normally used for the service. Reciprocating piston, double acting and triple acting, double X or triple X type pumps, mud pumps. Then stand pipes, so a rigid metal conduit that provides a high pressure pathway for drilling mud that will travel to 1/3 of way to the derrick, where it connects to the high pressure hose, that is Kelly hose. Then many large rigs are fitted with dual stand pipes so that the downtime is kept to a minimum if one stand pipes requires repaired or service. So these are all you can see in my other videos on solid control removal, solid control system in drilling fluids technology. Then your prime movers. So prime movers are nothing but it's used to give power to the drilling operations. So maybe steam engines, electric motors, internal combustion engines, etc. And the bulk of rig power is consumed in two operands, namely circulation of fluid and hoisting. See here only the power is more consumed. The next one. So the controlling system, that is well controlled, and comes to BOPs. If the formation pressure is more than the imposed by drilling fluid, then the formation fluids will flow into the borehole and eventually to the surface. This effect is called blowout, and there will be a development of kick. So you have to, so the main function of the blowout preventer is to close the annular space between the drill pipe and casing. So there is a function of your BOPs. So the, you can see here blind rams, shear rams, and choke line, etc. This is one of the important well control equipment, that is BOPs. So what are the advancement in rotary drilling? So directional drilling, horizontal drilling, multilateral drilling, CTD, coil tube drilling. So now we have the advanced ERD, extended reach drilling. So now underbalance drilling, to get your more economy in your oil well drilling, so underbalance drilling. So I put one more video also about the underbalance drilling, so you can watch it. Then MPD, manage pressure drilling. So these are the advancements in the rotary drilling. Then hazards, drilling hazards. So the tools which are dropped while drilling, the pipe will be stuck, the increased size of the hole and last circulation problem and slowing of the shale and development of kick, etc. So there are a lot of hazards. So oil field safety, you will see in separate presentation. And these are the links where you can find the presentations relevant to physics of oil and gas well drilling. So thank you. So today we have discussed briefly about the oil and gas well drilling, and also I have posted 2-3 links at the end of this presentation. You can go through it. Thank you. We'll see more on well drilling in our channel. Subscribe my channel. Thank you.
In this program, you'll learn how a drilling rig drills a hole, a well, in the ground. And you'll learn about the people it takes to run a rig and support a drilling operation. You'll also become familiar with the equipment, tools, and services that a rig needs to do this job. If a well is successful, if it encounters a formation containing hydrocarbons, then the oil company completes the well. That is, they install the equipment needed to produce hydrocarbons. The crew runs one final string of casing into the well. This casing string is the production string. A cement company crew cements the production string in the well. You've seen some of the skilled people it takes for a drilling rig to do its work. But it also takes equipment, a lot of equipment. To get a handle on rig equipment, let's divide it into four main systems. First, the power system. These big engines provide the power the rig needs to do its work. Second, the hoisting system. The hoisting system suspends the drill string and bit in the hole and provides a way for the driller to raise and lower the drill string. Besides the equipment and materials a rig uses to drill a well, personnel also need instruments and other devices to help them monitor drilling processes. For example, a weight indicator shows the driller weight on the bit as well as the load the hook is carrying. Several gauges also help the driller monitor the operation. For example, this gauge tells the driller the amount of pressure the mud pump is putting out. The latest rigs have computer displays that show the driller and the tool pusher virtually every parameter they need to monitor the drilling process.